Hello guys, and welcome to Manoeuvre Education Mumbai. And in my today's session of tort, we will study about the important element in the tort, which is a wrongful act and the legal damages. Now, when you will get a compensation for the damages done? This is the main question. So today we will study about the element which is very important. We'll study about the element which is very important. Wrongful act plus legal damages. Now, what is wrongful act? It is an act or omission, you know, it is an act or omission to do or not to do something which you were supposed to do. Okay, so this explanation ahead I'll give is, a person is made liable in tort if he has not done act of which he is out to have done, or has omitted, means not done, has omitted, not done an act which he is out to do. Okay, so if you have to do a particular act and if you have not done that act, or which you have not, you should have not done but you have done it, so in any of the case it will be a wrongful act. It will be a wrongful act. See, for example, municipal corporation omits to close sewage tank on road or fails to display warning to be aware. Now this is the duty of the municipal corporation to close the sewage tank, or at least put a signboard that, you know, there is a warning to be aware of it. If either of the things is not done by the municipal corporation, then the municipal corporation is at fault and it will fall in the category of a tort, because the legal rights of the people have been violated. It is a legal right of the people that, you know, all these facilities has to be provided by the municipal corporation. So in the eyes of law, it is a tort committed by the municipal corporation. And the plaintiff over here, if he, in case, you know, falls down in that sewage tank, then he can, you know, go to the court of law and he can say that my legal rights have been violated and I have, you know, got these damages and I have to be compensated from the municipal corporation. See, what are legal damages? It means violation of legal rights. Plaintiff has to prove his legal right has been violated. The onus, what does the word onus mean? The onus means is a, who has to prove first, who has to prove it. If a person over here, like a plaintiff, and who is a plaintiff? Is a plaintiff is a person who is suffering, you know, who is a sufferer, who is filing the complaint, because he is an aggrieved party, he is a sufferer. So over here he will be called as a plaintiff. So the onus is on the plaintiff to prove that, you know, his legal rights have been violated. The word legal damages means violation of legal rights. The word legal damages means violation. Violation means, what is the word violation means? Violation means that his legal rights have been, you know, broken, or they have been taken off. So the legal damages. So in eyes of law, where a tort will be committed only if there is a wrongful act and there are legal damages. Both the things has to be together. If there is a wrongful act but there are no legal damages, then you will not be entitled to any compensation. Then compensation, no compensation for such things. Yeah, if legal right, if there is a wrongful act and there are legal damages, then only you get a compensation. This will be more clear when I give you these two maxims. You know, what are types of violations? See, the violations means legal damages. Legal damages. There are two types of damages. Injuria sine damnum and damnum sine injuria. This is very, very important maxims. Okay, please. Injuria sine damnum. It means violation of legal rights without causing damage or loss to the plaintiff. See, violation of legal rights without causing damage or loss to the plaintiff. See, the important part is that the legal rights have been violated. There is some damage to your legal rights, but you have actually suffered no loss. So, can you claim damages from the court of law? Yes, you can. How? We will see. You will say, I have not caused, and there are no damages caused to me. Then why will they pay me? because your legal rights have been damaged. In law, the legal rights have more weightage than the actual damage. See, I'll give you an example. The defendant. Who is defendant? Defendant is a person who is not the suffering party, okay? Who is the opposite party, the plaintiff and the defendant. Defendant, a returning officer at a voting booth, refused to allow the plaintiff, a duly qualified voter, from voting. The candidate for whom the plaintiff was voting got elected. Now over here, what it is, say if you are a plaintiff, okay, and there is an election going on and you wanted to, you know, vote for Narendra Modi, okay. So now the defendant, but a returning officer at the booth, he somehow, you know, told that you are not supposed to vote, though you are a qualified voter, but he did not allow you to vote. So the candidate to whom the plaintiff, means you are the plaintiff, so you were supposed to vote, got elected. You were supposed to vote for Narendra Modi and he got elected in spite of you not voting him. There was no loss suffered by him. So there was no loss suffered by you over here, because the person whom you wanted to vote, that is Narendra Modi, already got elected, even if you not voting him. The court held that although the plaintiff did not sustain any actual loss, but his legal rights to vote was violated, for which he was granted a remedy. See over here, what is important is there is a violation of legal rights without causing damage or loss to the plaintiff. Do you understand, students, over here? It is that though you were, you know, not allowed to vote, in spite of that Narendra Modi got elected, so there is no actual loss to you, but the loss was your legal right to vote was violated, so you were granted the compensation, so you were granted the remedy. Okay, in tort, when you have a compensation, it can be called as a remedy also. So that is the maxim over here, is injuria sine damnum, where it means violation of legal rights without causing damage or loss to the plaintiff. Damnum sine injuria, this is another second type of a violation. It means damage has been caused without violation of plaintiff's legal right and no action lies against the defendant. Over here, though, although there is an actual loss, then also plaintiff cannot take any action against the defendant. How? We'll see, this example will make it more clear to you. A sets up a rival school opposite to B school with a low fee structure. Okay, now B already had an ongoing school, you know, and in the premises, just in a corresponding to it, just adjacent to it, A sets up a new school with a low fee structure, as a result of which students from B school flock to A school, thereby causing a huge financial loss to A. Here there is an actual loss. It is an actual loss suffered by whom? By A. Okay, actual loss suffered by A. This act of A is not actionable in law of tort, since it did not lead to the violation of any legal right. See what happens. A is actually, you know, has all the legal rights to set up a school. There is no law written that you cannot set up another school in connecting to an ongoing school. So here no, you know, rights of B's have been violated. No doubt there is an actual loss suffered, but A has full right to do it. So here what the court has held is this act of A is not actionable in law of tort, since it did not lead to the violation of any legal right of the plaintiff, although he has sustained financial loss. इसका मतलब ये होता है कि अगर आपको एक्चुअली नुकसान हुआ है, लेकिन आपको लीगली आप कुछ भी नहीं कर पाओगे, इट इज़ फॉर दैट रीज़न. This act of A is not actionable in law of torts, since it did not lead to the violation of any legal right of the plaintiff, although he has sustained financial loss. So damnum sine injuria, in case of damnum sine injuria, you will not get any remedy. You will not get any remedy, although the loss has been suffered. I hope this much is clear to you. And for more information, you can visit our site manoeuvre.edu.com. And if you want to join us for the online programs, then you can click here and check out our online programs. If any query regarding course or exams, you can call on 8828581455 or 8828581454 for appearing for the law entrance. And all the best, and thank you.